Cameraman, what are you doing? Cameraman, are you filming them? Okay, cameraman, back to me. That's the last you're ever going to be focusing on them. Because for the next few minutes of your life, if you're going to get a sneak preview of what it's like to be a future two-time Singapore champion.
Good morning. I'd like to book your big haul in.
We received word that the WWE scouts are going to come down to Singapore to take a look at us. Chances are they want to beef up their pool of Southeast Asian talents. I'm really excited because this is the next stage for the wrestlers. But right now, ticket sales are still quite low.
All right, Dragon Mania, Dragon Mania.
I think the scouts might perceive us as a bit of a backyard amateur show.
Mr. Froese is doing work. He's, you know, slaving night and day. He's slaving night and day for the sake of our promotion, yes?
Apart from that, I'm also nanny to the wrestlers.
He's your hero.
Kenneth and I, we are two sides of the same coin. I'm very straight-talking.
Happy birthday, Mr. Froese.
Kenneth is over the top. It's like he takes the Eurasian Dragon persona as a free pass to do whatever he wants.
I tell you what, you do it quietly. I just do my business, man.
Don't go, Grandpa. I love you. Can you stay?
My work is done.
Cameraman, please. Please, cameraman, stop blocking.
Yes.
What a nice day in the home of the Eurasian Dragon. I have neighbours. People live here as well, not just me. The core of the Eurasian Dragon's character is his self-belief. He thinks he's a very intelligent guy. Everything he says, you know, like his word is gospel. Hey brother, when you hear the voice from above, when you hear the voice of the Eurasian Dragon, the one thing that attracts me the most are the larger-than-life characters. You're the captain of Team Singapore. The one thing I wanted to do is to show the audience how the Eurasian Dragon trains. Bam! A kick to the person's shin. Bam! There you go. Because that's the character I play, you know, like, it's just centered on absurdity. Hey man, it's a rain. Open umbrella, it's good. Rain falling.
You mean before or after the show?
I'm Singapore's first female pro wrestler in SPW for the past 4 years.
How are you going to prepare for your match against Boney? Funny, is it?
My parents are against wrestling. They want me to fit into the typical gentle women stereotype. They've been asking me to quit for almost on a daily basis. And that was not easy to battle.
Drop kick, throw punch.
I'm facing the stress from trying to keep up with the rest of the guys in the ring and to feel that pressure from my parents.
I have high hopes for Alexis Lee. I think Alexis Lee stands a very good chance to be in the WWE. Even though she may not be as big as most of the female wrestlers, what I can see from her is her heart. You know, she puts in the dedication, she shows the passion, she shows the fire, the willingness to learn.
It was hard working with guys because I wasn't improving at like the same rate as them. So I was grateful that I got pushed by Andrew for that.
Call her, I will tie up.
Any special introductions? We usually fill up about a 500 maximum capacity, but what happened was we were booked it on the worst possible day. Chinese New Year reunion dinner night. Effectively, I'm losing the entire Chinese demographic of Singapore. So the big question is whether people will really show up. Are they willing to leave their reunion dinner tables?
Fifth anniversary show, SPW Unchained in Changi, emanating from Changi.
In order for a story to really start taking on a larger scope, you've got to have like larger targets. I went straight for the biggest man in the room, Mighty Mighty.
So I don't get how this man can drink carbonated drinks by the boatload. How do you survive? How do you manage to become the tag team champion?
I don't know why, most of the time he likes to make fun of me at the same time. Like, I keep hearing 6,000 pounds, 6,000 pounds on Mighty Mighty. No, it's 350 pounds.
350,000 pounds, that's what he's just corrected me.
I was just trying to promote health. You know, there are young men out there who are not treating their health seriously and they should look at Mighty Mighty, who is kind of like a recovering addict.
What's up?
That was your 15 seconds of fame right there, man.
Wrestling has changed me. I was the odd one out. I was not confident. And ever since I stepped in the ring, I managed to kind of break the ceiling for myself. I could never be more grateful for the spot.
The show's starting soon. Hopefully, the boys and girls will be able to step up. I'm losing my majority audience, which is the entire Chinese demographic of Singapore. But we're still going ahead with it because we've already booked talents from America, Europe, Russia, all around Southeast Asia also. We've got a few hundred in ticket sales right now. But will they show up?
We're gonna start at 8:15. If no more questions, everyone have a great event.
A good show is when everyone performs well. But most importantly, the fans need to go home feeling like they watched a show that was a lot more valuable than the price of their ticket.
For me, a good match would be when the fans are cheering throughout the entire match. And even if I may have lost, I know that they would still be supporting me.
We have fears when we go into the ring. I worry, like, what if my opponent has, like, a stomach ache or something, and then I give him, like, a clothesline, he falls and he craps himself in the ring.
My scouting process in a night like tonight is to just first be sort of a blank slate. Who catches my eye with their movement, with their presentation, with their dynamic charisma, with their athleticism. We want to bring back to the WWE Performance Center and make wrestlers superstars.
It was a very different audience, but that produced a very different reaction.
It was pretty funny because, like, you see, like, people, Malay people, white people, Malay, Malay, white, white, Indian community, cousins and friends. Oh, look, two Chinese token. We started with nothing, no background, nothing. And here we are today attracting like the eyes of the top talent scouts in the world.
We want the best athletes in the world to become sports entertainers for WWE. You need to be diverse. They need different sizes, shapes, athletic backgrounds, etc. Some of them passed, some of them didn't. my job to help decide which of them get, you know, a break that could change their lives. So it's exciting.
The thing that not many people may understand is that wrestling is actually a very, very painful sport. Every time you crash land, your body, you know, it takes a toll on your body, and there's never really getting used to it.
If pro wrestling was to become my official and only career choice, I would take it because it's not something I would give up easily.
We should be looking out for the show, but you need to look out for yourself also so that the show makes you look good.
Everyone wants to be the top. Everyone wants to succeed in wrestling. But at the same time, because we keep training together and we keep like hanging out together, so I guess it's kind of like a friendly fire, like within the family kind of rivalry.
I'm happy with the number of people who turned up for this show, but I'm just looking forward to an even bigger show. 2017, 2018 are looking very bright for all of the SPW boys and girls, because I see many of them being called up by the WWE. They're gonna finally get their time in the sun.
I'll see you again at the next Singapore Professional Wrestling event. Thank you!
Cameraman, zoom.
Welcome to the greatest show for anyone that wants to know. There's Royce, the Dragon, Alexis Lee. Hey, cameraman.
Look at
I'm on the ropes. I'm on the ropes. I'm on the ropes. I'm on the ropes. But it ain't me.